Thank you so much for coming tonight, CS. Can I ask why you have initials rather than a name? I'm so curious about that.
You know, I have a Chinese name, and and CS is actually a lot easier to pronounce. Funny story behind that, I was actually born here. My parents gave me a Chinese name, and they took English names. So they're Agnes and Andy.
It's the Bay Area, isn't it?
Yeah, they're maybe a little ahead of the time. I don't know.
Okay. Well, thank you for that. I was wondering what HSBC is looking at as far as fintech goes, and how they're integrating that into their strategy.
I think at HSBC, we're really looking to be at the forefront, in the changes in technology. So for us, we're really looking for strategic partnerships with fintechs, where we can improve our user experience. We can add value to our clients, and that's really what we're looking at. The most with these fintechs, because they are definitely tackling a lot of difficult issues and questions, and we want to be part of that and be part of that conversation.
Right. And what's your personal vision and ideas about where you think fintech startups and the banks are going to go?
I think it's very exciting. I think it's going to be a very collaborative approach. You know, I think both fintechs and banks have a lot to gain, really working on what they do best, so that what the banks can look at what they're doing on the operational side, and these fintechs can work at, you know, again, improving that user experience or making things more efficient. And by partnering up, they can use their own resources and, you know, focus on those issues. You know, with HSBC being such a large bank, we're in 70 different countries. So we can really help these startups look at more global view, and also, you know, help them really shape their product and what they're trying to do. So I think there's going to be a lot of collaboration.
I noticed that the fintech is much. I've been doing this for a year with the meetups, Silicon Valley fintech meetup and Bay Area fintech meetup, and I've noticed in over that year that definitely it's a bit slower here than it is, say, in Asia or even Australia, where I'm originally from. And Europe. And so I kept asking that question, why is that? But I guess the fact is there is a lot of action happening in Asia, and I guess HSBC is sort of in the heart of that, I would imagine.
We're very excited, being the largest foreign bank in Asia. And I think, you know, it was what's been happening in Asia has been amazing. I mean, the growth, the largest fintechs in the world are in Asia right now. And it was really because of the banking industry was really focused on the high end, the larger clients. So with this burgeoning middle class, they didn't really have the services that they could provide these services to these people. So, and, you know, large companies like Ant Financial came in and backed by Alibaba, and were able to do things that you would be amazed that they can stay within one platform and do all kinds of tasks. So they've been able to bundle everything. And I think that is definitely a trend. Mm-hmm. Now, it may not happen in the rest of the world, where we're bound by more regulatory issues. But in China, I think that's really what helped fuel that, especially with all the mobile phones and the adoption. And, you know, I think I read the other day something like 75% of all payments are done by mobile.
We had a fintech in China panel a long time ago, but I know they were saying that when they're in China, they don't even use cash, and then as soon as they get back here, they have to pull their cash out again, and that it's so much more convenient. So I think the future's bright, really, and I'm sure that things will change here too. Thank you so much for coming, and I really look forward to the panel.
Likewise, thank you for having me.